What's happening, Munchers? My name is Harsh.
And I'm Shreyas.
Welcome back to Good Band Filmy, and we're getting you
into the depths and the details of Joker.
Absolutely. This is going to be a complete spoiler video, so be brace yourselves. If you've not seen the non-spoiler video, you should see a link up here somewhere. Yeah.
Float in.
Yeah, absolutely. So check that out with Nessa non-spoiler review.
Yeah.
And this video is definitely going to be spoiler heavy.
You.
So watch this after you've seen that video, and do yourself a favor, watch it ASAP.
Man. Absolutely.
Stop watching this video for the moment.
Yo.
Yeah.
Let's get into it.
Absolutely. Let's get into this.
So the fact that we've never seen a Joker like this, where we're seeing origins, we're seeing him as a usual guy having usual problems,
right.
Supposedly. There's never been any explanation about how our current Jokers, in terms of how they reach that level of madness, what their motivations are. And that's what makes Joker Joker. He's very like random and ambiguous.
Absolutely.
The fact that here we see him with his mental illness, we don't even know why he was in the asylum.
Right.
They just show him freaking banging his head. And I was like, whoa, that's messed up. He's on heavy medication, and that laugh, like we thought there could be no different laugh. Jared Leto tried it, but here the fact that it's a freaking condition, that it pains his body to do that, that is not even a voluntary response.
Every time he's nervous or he's scared, he starts laughing, and that's it's an actual condition. He goes around handing cards to people that I have a condition.
To explain.
It's done brilliantly. The fact that you've utilized something like this to, you know, show what kind of guy this guy is.
And reach that level.
Absolutely, man. It's done really well. And Joaquin Phoenix and his laugh.
Jesus.
Dude, it got under my skin. I had goosebumps every time it happened. There are times when he's doing the fake laugh, you know, around his peers and
everything. Yeah.
And it just gets to you, man.
I mean, even from the trailer, one of my favorite scenes is like he's walking in a corridor, and it's an L-shaped corridor, and he's walking.
Laughing.
Yeah, he looks normal. He looks, you know, whatever. He's walking, and then he laughs, and then he goes back to being normal. And
suddenly, like, he's gonna snap.
Yeah. And I'm like, that's so messed up.
Yeah.
But when you watch the movie, now you know why, and
now
it's
it happened,
all the more like, oh. So yeah, so just you know, sowing the seeds and setting the seeds to see what's going on and how it's going on was insane. And then, just the final card, that final bit in that domino thing of him just losing his shit is, you see how everyone's against him, the city, his peers, his colleagues, how everyone's backstabbing him, how everyone's literally running over him. But when it happens with his mom,
that's the final push for him, I'm guessing.
That is the final push.
Everybody hates him.
Yeah.
No, not hates him, everyone's just picking on him because he's like a loser, more or less.
Right.
And he has a mental illness, so he can't connect with people. He's socially insecure, socially awkward. He can't get, you know, gel with people and everything.
The stand-up bits, bro.
Absolutely.
That's messed up.
It's messed up and it's mesmerizing at the same time.
Yes.
And then Joaquin Phoenix, the way he's acting, where he's just covering his mouth and he's just laughing.
He's trying to control
his nervousness and people are just making fun of him and shit.
Right.
It's done so well. And then the bit with the mother happens. Something happens with the mother.
Yeah.
And then he kind of finds out that he's Thomas Wayne's illegitimate child.
Supposedly. We don't know to what
it's
extent.
It's left ambiguous, and I think that works really well in favor of the movie.
Yes.
And just that reveal and how he starts feeling that he needs to go up to Thomas Wayne, you know, kind of
like just talk it out and see what's real.
That becomes like the final push to descend into madness.
Oh my god.
And then the kind of axe that he pulls off, my god, just creeped the shit out of me, and I loved every second of it.
Yeah, I mean, we all know that, you know, the most dangerous people are the ones that have nothing to lose.
Absolutely.
And I think it starts with his mom, because once he gets rid of his mom, He's literally a nobody. His name doesn't matter.
Initially, they've done a really good job of establishing their relationship. He's
correct.
In love with his mom.
Yeah, he's taking care of her.
Absolutely, all the time. And she is the only person that he can actually talk to at all.
Yeah.
So that they've established a nice relationship.
Yes.
And then something just goes wrong.
Yeah.
I want you guys to witness the face that what happens there. But yeah, something goes wrong and then it's just...
Yeah, then it's just free flow. It's wave after wave of just too much happening. And we always assume the thought that there's not much of Batman going on here.
Right.
But we saw Thomas Wayne in the trailer. We saw a little Chotu Bruce in the trailer. There's so much going on with that. And we actually, I mean, it's easy enough to figure out that one thing leads to another, and then it leads to another, and this whole Batman causing Joker causing Batman is actually a loop. It's one causing the other, and
it's
that's just
done so well. I thought it'd be a little, you know, tacky maybe.
Yeah.
Now when I saw it, I'm just in love with it. The fact that Batman, Joker calls Batman calls Joker calls Batman.
Yeah, so basically, so it's Thomas Wayne creates Joker. Yeah. Joker's creation creates Batman.
It's the way it's done is fantastic. Right. Todd Phillips, the entire crew, the entire cast, right. Joaquin Phoenix,
right.
Robert De Niro, as he beats, everyone's done a fantastic job. I can't emphasize on it enough. Man.
Yeah, and we were wondering whether this could be a Black Label alternative universe kind of thing.
That's something Todd Phillips actually, you know, after he made the movie, he actually went up to them and pitched, like, why don't we start doing these Black Label movies that are like elsewhere stories and, you know, like something completely different,
right.
not part of the DCU, like this movie is.
Right.
And I think after the kind of response that this movie's gotten, I think DC and Warner Bros. Might just buy into it. So that's
No. Get Robert Pattinson, bro. Let's do Batman. Yeah, but we were trying to figure out because obviously Joker's in his 40s. He's
absolutely
full on into it, and Bruce is still a kid. Like he's just created.
He's small,
the whole Batman thing is just starting. So we wanted to figure out that by the time he's old enough to be Batman, is it Joaquin Phoenix or Arthur Fleck playing Joker, or does he inspire another Joker?
So by the end of the movie, he more or less starts like a revolution where people are, you know, putting on Joker masks and, you know, they're kind of like going out in the streets and wrecking shit. They're going up against all the rich people. There's like this, there are these proper riots breaking out in Gotham City, and that's what I loved about Gotham City. Gotham City is like that. It's a place where people would revolt if they think something's being wrong.
Chaos.
They've been wronged, or there's always chaos. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So just the fact that they've shown it so freaking well.
That end scene, man, where he's battered and bloody, but he stands up to everyone, like cheering him on, and then he goes into his freaking dancing, snaking mode, and
it's done fantastic. And just then I got thinking, I'm like, what if this is not the real Joker? This is the guy who inspires the guy who becomes the clown.
Right.
And it's left ambiguous, and
I
really like that. I really.
Right. And that's so funny because you're trying to show a Joker origin story, but you're still trying to stay true to the ambiguity part of it.
Absolutely.
That's insane.
And I think they've nailed it here.
They have. I mean, Todd Phillips, everyone else, freaking amazing. Warner Bros. Well done. You guys usually suck. But another thing that I really like, and inevitably, you'll always have your Heath Ledger versus Joaquin Phoenix.
Absolutely, man.
And what kind of put me off a little bit, unfairly so, is that in the videos, I saw his green hair, and I'm like, why are they doing the same length of hair? Is it coincidence? But obviously, when you see the movie, the makeup's not exactly the same, obviously. And it's so weird. Like, I remember there's a scene right in the beginning where he's applying makeup, and it's almost like he's crying.
He is crying.
Yeah, and because of the makeup, you can very clearly see the tears stream down, you know, sort of mixed with the paint. And if you notice, whenever he has that on, even right in the end, when he's in full Joker mode, one sort of part will always have that tear streak. And that's insane. And from him to be this loser, downtrodden, everyone's picking on him, to even when he's this in his mode, oh my god, he is so full of confidence.
As soon as he puts on the makeup, puts on, you know...
Dude, the part when he's...
You're mesmerized by him.
Yeah, the part when he's walking out of the subway bit and you have cops like running helter-skelter, and he's just like in his mode, he's smoking a cigarette everywhere. In the hospital, in like studios, everywhere.
Yeah.
That's just... It's like he is just giving us different ways of being badass.
Absolutely.
And ways we didn't think possible, and this just shows that. So damn, there's so much going on.
This movie is being carried by Joaquin Phoenix
totally.
End to end. It's just him. He's there on 98% of the times. It's just him on the screen. Yeah. The supporting cast is there, sprinkled throughout really well again.
Just to push and nudge.
The whole buzz surrounding him, and then Oscar buzz. If he doesn't even get nominated, I think this is going to be the biggest.
Then we can write.
Then we should write. Absolutely. Wearing Joker mask.
Have our own V for Vendetta revolution going on.
Absolutely.
But yeah, that's about it. I hope we spoiled it enough.
I'm definitely going to watch it again. I think this movie deserves second viewing.
For sure.
Second, third, fourth. I'm definitely going to go see it multiple times.
Yeah.
So yeah, let us know in the comments below how you like the movie and what was the thing that just took you by surprise. What you loved about this movie in the comments below.
Yo.
Like, share, subscribe as usual. Thank you so much for watching this video.
Yeah.
Be back for more, guys.
Yo.
Love you. Cheers.